Climate change has been called the pressing health issue of our time. We're really seeing some of those impacts right in front of our faces today.
Everything that we're worried about in public health, health equity, agricultural output and nutrition, you can name many other things that we're really concerned about, and all of them are potentially made worse or exacerbated by climate change.
Extreme heat and flooding and increases in pollen levels are all really important issues that we need to look at. Extreme heat can cause a lot of loss of life. In Detroit, for example, on really warm days, you can see increases in mortality of 40%. We're in the middle of a project. We received funding from the National Institutes of Environmental Health Sciences using some Medicare data that we got from the Institute from Healthcare Policy and Innovation, along with some really fine scale health and environmental information, trying to understand who is most vulnerable to extreme heat. A lot of these like environmental vulnerability maps floating around right now, and we want to see how varying assumptions that goes into those maps affects the way that you identify the most vulnerable areas. Climate models are showing that in this region of the United States, we're expecting more precipitation. With extreme precipitation events and basement flooding, you get mold growth. And you can also get sewage in your basements in some instances. We are also seeing that higher levels of carbon dioxide in the air actually increases the allergenicity of certain species of pollen. So it's likely that we'll see increases in asthma and allergy attacks with climate change.
We've got vector-borne illnesses that are going to be spreading in broader geographic areas as the climate warms. We have natural disasters, hurricanes and wildfires that we're seeing more of and more intense. All the social determinants of health are going to be the exact populations that are going to be most affected by climate events.
Disasters affect different communities in different ways and definitely affect populations differently. We've seen recently how federal involvement in disasters has been inequitable towards populations that have been traditionally structurally marginalized. My work looks at how do health outcomes differ, how does access to care differ, and how can we bring about interventions and strategies to better support populations after disasters. Some of the common things that I think about a lot are people who need prescription refills or medication adjustments. They can't get those because they don't have access to their primary care. I think there's kind of a number of voids across the climate and health spectrum right now. So there's huge opportunities for research advancements.
There's some momentum building around these issues within kind of the healthcare policy world. The Department of Health and Human Services recently established an Office of Climate and Health Equity, and that will be the first time that climate has been a focus within HHS broadly, with a focus on policy and what regulatory levers might be used to try to both allow the healthcare system to respond to climate issues, but also to help decarbonize them.